This is the Godox X2T trigger for Canon. In this video, I will be taking you through the process of getting started with this trigger. So from up here we have groups A, B, C, D, and E. This is the test button. And this button has other uses. You can use it to capture pictures of yourself. When you short press it, you can see it turns green. And when you press it fully, it turns red. So when it turns green, you can use it to focus your camera. And to take the picture, you press it fully. I will expound that later. Here we have a Bluetooth icon, which means this trigger has Bluetooth capabilities. Here we have the mode button, menu button, set button. Down here we have the scroll wheel. This is the rocking mechanism. Here we have on and off. This is the focus assist beam. This helps your camera find subject in the dark by projecting a beam from this area and directing that beam of light to your subject. This is the battery compartment. I have some rechargeable AA batteries. And this is the hot shoe mount. If you had dialed any settings and you want us to get started setting up this trigger afresh, turn your trigger off, press and hold the mode button and turn it on. This will reset the trigger so that we can set it up afresh. Now, this is how the trigger looks out of the box. We have the mode button. We have the menu button. And let us first see what we have here. We have the sync setting, Bluetooth, beeping sound, zoom setting, scan channel ID, PC sync, delay, shoot function, distance, step, group, standby, right, LCD right, LCD brightness. Now sync setting, because we are going to use this trigger as a master, we need to set it as high speed sync, which means this trigger will be commanding your flashes. Click set. Bluetooth function, let us not turn it on for now. We will turn it on later when I show you how you use the Bluetooth app. The beeping sound, I normally set it to on because I need those confirmations. Zoom. Now you can set your zoom to auto, or you can set your zoom to match the focal length of your camera. But because sometimes you keep forgetting, just set it to auto. Now scanning will help you find the available channels that do not have interferences, which means there won't be smooth communication between your flashes and your lens trigger. So click on start. This will take a few seconds and you should be able to see the available channels that do not have any form of interference. These are the available channels, and in my case I will select channel 5. going around to channel, click on set and go all the way down to channel 5. Click set. And now when you are a group of people, you are doing photography, you need to identify yourself. But now that in this tutorial we are talking about when you are shooting alone, I don't think you need to use the ID. PC sync, when you set it to in, this flash will be receiving command out, it will be sending commands to others. Delay, let us set delay to off. Shoot function, when you are shooting alone and when you want to share your parameters with others, if you are shooting in a group, you select the group. But in my case here, I am shooting alone, so I will set on that one. Distance, this is dependent on how far you are from your subject. It could be 1 to 100, 0 to 30 meters. So where your subject is where your flashes will be. That is the distance you need to measure between where this trigger is and where your subject is. Step. Now on the step here, this is about the amount of power increment, and you have several of them. You could use this one of 128 with small increments, three of them between. You could use this other one, but most of the time people use this one because many people use it, so people get used to this amount of power increment, 1/28, three small increments in between. Then you go to 1/64. Group. Now it is advisable to use all the groups. If you have 5 groups, maybe you have 5 flashes, you want each of them to contribute a certain amount of power, select all of them. But if you don't want to use many flashes or many sets of flashes, you can select the 3 groups A to C, A, B and C. But in my case here, I'll select all of them. Now when it comes to standby, how long do you want the LCD to be on before it goes to sleep? Let me set it to 30 minutes. I don't want to look at it only to find that it has gone to dim. Right. LCD right. I want to keep it on all the time. So standby is before your flash even goes to sleep. Right is about LCD right. This is LCD brightness. This is LCD brightness. Let me set it to 0 just as it is factory set. Sync. And now I think we have set all the settings because we are back to sync. Now let us talk about how you can use this button to take pictures of yourself. You see, when you are shooting on by yourself and you want to take pictures of yourself, there are several ways you can do it. You can autofocus on an area and stand in that area, and you only hope that your camera will catch you in focus. But now with this trigger, if you have 2 of these triggers, there is this port here, there is the shutter release cable, which one end you can attach here and the other end you will attach to the camera shutter release port. Once that is done, then the other flash trigger, because now you need to set it to the same group as this one that is connected to the camera and set them to the same channel. When you do that, this trigger will be commanding the other trigger to focus by half pressing it, and when you fully press it, the camera will take the picture. So you can use this trigger to take pictures of yourself. Do not be left out in the group photo because you are the one pressing the trigger, or you are the one pressing the shutter button. About the group, the Bluetooth. So you can use this trigger remotely through the phone app. What the phone app does is it helps you control the flashes, storm flashes. And how you do that is you install the Godox flash app and you turn the Bluetooth on. Once you turn the Bluetooth on the Godox flash app, you will scan for the available devices and this one will be found. Once you find this trigger, you connect it. Now under this trigger, let's say group A, you have set this flash to group A. Then the storm light, you have set it to group B. In the flash app, there will be the group A and group B. And when you are doing something like video, you could control the power of the storm light through the phone app. And when you want to take picture at the same time, you could control the power of the flash with the scroll wheel here or just with the phone. So it gives you different options, but because sometimes you have video rights that they're using for photography, you also have spin rights like this one, then the app gives you that versatility. You are able to control all of them from the phone. Now to connect this trigger to the flash, we have set it to group A, channel 5. So what we need to do is go to a spin right here and select group. And set it to group A. It is already set to channel 5 and high spin sync is turned on. And now the flash is functioning. So when you want to change the power, press on group A and you can set the power as you prefer. JM Photography KG Image Mix.